Hello everyone. Today in the part 23 of the NEET PG important questions, we will discuss about the questions related to the osteology of the clavicle, scapula and the humerus bone. So first try to answer the question by yourself. Now what are the peculiarities of the clavicle bone? So it is the only long bone which is lying horizontally. It has absolutely no medullary cavity. It is subcutaneous throughout its extent. It is the first bone to start ossifying, and also it is the last bone to finish the ossification about at 25 years of age. It is the only long bone which is ossified by two primary centers. It is the only long bone which ossifies in membrane other than its medial end. It might be pierced inside out by the cutaneous nerve or the intermediate supraclavicular nerve. Which is the first bone to start ossification? It is of course the clavicle bone. Which is the second bone to start ossification? It is the mandible bone. The last bone to complete ossification? It is the clavicle, which actually completes its ossification about at 25 years of age. Now which is the growing end of the clavicle? It is the medial end. Weight or the force of upper limb is transmitted mainly through which ligament? Through the coracoclavicular ligament. How many ossification centers do clavicle has? It has two primary and one secondary centers of ossification. Interclavicular ligaments, articular disc, costoclavicular ligament are present at which end of the clavicle? They are present at the sternal end of the clavicle. Sternal end of the clavicle at the sternoclavicular joint are covered by fibrocartilage. Posterior surface of the sternal end of the clavicle is related to subclavian vein, brachiocephalic vein and the internal jugular vein. Supraclavicular nerve commonly piercing the clavicle is, it is the intermediate supraclavicular nerve. Scapula overlaps on posterior chest wall against which ribs? Against the 2nd to 7th ribs. Scapula is homologous with the ilium. Delta tubercle is present on clavicle and spine of scapula. Location of conoid tubercle of the clavicle is, it is present at the junction of the lateral 1/4 and the medial 3/4 on the inferior surface. Smallest surface of the medial end of the clavicle is the inferior one. Nutrient foramen of clavicle is located on the inferior surface in which part of the subclavius groove? In the lateral part of the subclavius groove. In females, acromial end as compared to sternal end of the clavicle is lower. Most reliable indicator of sex determination of the clavicle is the midshaft circumference. Weakest part of the clavicle is, it is a junction between the lateral 1/3 and the medial 2/3. Head of scapula is represented by glenoid cavity. Superior border of the scapula is related to which artery? To the suprascapular artery. Medial border of the scapula is related to which artery? To the transverse scapular artery and the descending branch of it. Lateral border of the scapula is related to which artery? To the circumflex scapular artery. Inferior angle of scapula overlaps which rib? It overlaps the 7th rib. Which tubercle is inside the capsule of the shoulder joint? Supraglenoid tubercle. Muscles attached to the inferior angle of the scapula are serratus anterior muscle, teres major and the latissimus dorsi muscle. Superior angle of scapula is crossed by which nerve? By the spinal accessory nerve. Apex of the spine of scapula lies at the level of which vertebra? Spine of T3 vertebra. Precoracoid bone corresponds to pubis. Scapula is ossified by how many centers? By 8 centers. Primary center for scapula appears at which time of intrauterine life? By the 8th week of intrauterine life. Primary center of scapula appears for body of the scapula and the lower two-third of the glenoid cavity. Centers of ossification for coracoid process appears at first year of life. Head of humerus roughly forms how much of the sphere? It forms one-third of the sphere. Head of humerus is directed medially, posteriorly and upwards. What is the angle of humeral torsion? It is 164 degrees. Where is the articular cartilage of head of humerus is thinnest and thickest? So it is the articular cartilage, which is a subvariety of hyaline cartilage, is thinnest at the periphery and thickest at the center. Lesser tuberosity at the upper end of the humerus projects anteriorly. Greater tuberosity at the upper end of the humerus projects laterally. Greater tuberosity is covered by subacromial bursa and deltoid, and it forms the round contour of the shoulder. Which muscle forms the rotator cuff of the shoulder joint? So these are four: subscapularis, supraspinatus, infraspinatus and the teres minor muscle. Surgical neck of the humerus is related to which vessels? To the axillary nerve, posterior circumflex humeral artery. What is morphological neck of the humerus? It is seen in the young humerus and it is the epiphyseal line between the upper epiphysis and the diaphysis. In adults, it disappears. The capsule of the shoulder joint is attached to which neck of the humerus bone? It is attached to the anatomical neck of the humerus bone. What are the attachments at the intertubercular sulcus? So at the lateral lip, there is pectoralis major muscle. At the medial lip, there is teres major muscle. And at the floor, there is erysipelas dorsi muscle. Which muscle has the longest attachment at the intertubercular sulcus? So pectoralis major muscle has the longest attachment at the intertubercular sulcus. Which muscle has the shortest attachment at the intertubercular sulcus? It is the latissimus dorsi muscle. Where is the Newton artery of the humerus directed, and it is a branch of? So the Newton artery is located close to the medial border of the humerus and is directed downwards, and it is a branch of the brachial artery. Medial intermuscular septum of the humerus is pierced by ulnar nerve, superior ulnar collateral artery and the posterior branch of the inferior ulnar collateral artery. Now the ligament of Struthers represent. So ligament of Struthers basically represent the third head of the coracobrachialis. Ligament of Struthers is attached to what of the humerus? They are attached to the medial condyle of the humerus. Which vessels may be compressed by ligament of Struthers? So brachial artery and the median nerve. Lateral intermuscular septum is pierced by radial nerve and the anterior descending branch of the profunda brachii artery. What is the location of the spiral groove of the humerus? It is located on the posterior surface of the humerus in the middle one-third, above the origin of the lateral head of triceps and below brachialis muscle. Spiral groove of the humerus contains the radial nerve and the profunda brachii artery. Now what is the carrying angle? It is 163 degrees. Carrying angle disappears during the full flexion of the elbow and the pronation of the forearm. Non-articular parts of the lower end of the humerus are radial fossa, coronoid and the olecranon fossa, and the lateral and the medial epicondyles. Articular parts of the lower end of the humerus are capitulum and the trochlea. Radial fossa of the humerus, which is located above the capitulum, accommodates what? It accommodates margins of the head of radius in the full flexion. Olecranon fossa of the humerus on the posterior surface of the humerus above trochlea lodges which structures? It lodges the apex of the coronoid process of the ulna in the extended elbow. Now what are the features of the medial epicondyle of the humerus? So the medial epicondyle of the humerus is larger and palpable as compared to the lateral epicondyle of the humerus. The ulnar nerve is rated posteriorly to the medial epicondyle of the humerus and the attachment of the ulnar collateral ligament is actually present at the medial epicondyle of the humerus. Which epicondyle or the fossa lie inside or outside the capsular ligament of the elbow joint? So here, radial, coronoid and the olecranon fossa are inside and both the epicondyle are outside the capsular ligament. Humerus is ossified by how many centers? By one primary and seven secondary centers. Secondary center for head of the humerus appears at first year of life. Secondary center for lesser tuberosity of the humerus appears at 5th year of life. Secondary center for greater tubercle of the humerus appears at 2nd year of life. All secondary center for the upper end of humerus fuse to become one at 6th year of life. Secondary center for medial epicondyle of the humerus appears at 5th year of life. Secondary center for capitulum of the humerus appears at 2nd year of life. Secondary center for lateral flange of the trochlea of the humerus appears at 2nd year of life. Secondary center for medial flange of the trochlea of the humerus appears at 10th year of life. Growing end of the humerus is the upper end. Nutrient artery to the humerus is a branch from the brachial artery. The poorest blood supply of the humerus is at junction of the upper one third and the middle one third. So today up till here we'll discuss about the further important notes and MCQs of further important topics in our next video. Thank you so much.